Well, today was my first meeting with Mr. Raab since he's become Secretary of State for the Department for Exiting the European Union. It was a very positive first encounter. By way of background, you should know that Dominic Raab was actually a Foreign Office legal advisor in the period between 2000 and 2006 when Gibraltar was getting its new constitution. He was involved in that. Therefore, he knows some of the granular detail of how Gibraltar works constitutionally. That's always helpful, not having to explain what the level of responsibility that Gibraltar enjoys is versus the level of responsibility that the United Kingdom retains. And so there was a good meeting of minds, a good understanding that we're all rowing in the same direction, that Brexit is going to happen one way or another, and we have to prepare for that eventuality, whether it happens with a deal or it happens without a deal. And my meetings with Dominic Raab were about that, what happens in the context of the negotiations and the discussions, and what happens in the context also of there being no deal if the discussions and negotiations don't come to the right conclusion.
Your meeting was held in Downing Street. Were you able to pick up any nuances as to what the government plans to do with the Chequers plan? Are they sticking to it word by word, or is there going to be some sort of reworking of it, do you think?
I think the Prime Minister has done the right thing. She has said to her European counterparts, you tell me you don't like what I've proposed, come back and give me your counter-offer. I'm not going to put a new offer myself, because then I'm negotiating against myself. And that's absolutely, of course, the right position to take. She has said she's going to go away and look at different options in respect of Northern Ireland. And my understanding of what happened in the cabinet meeting on Monday is that people have coalesced around that position. And what we're going to see as we go into the crucial party conference season for the Prime Minister, the Tory party conference starts on Sunday, and I'll be there in Birmingham, is that we're going to see how the process develops through party conference and what emerges thereafter.
You're also at the Labour Party conference where Keir Starmer made that speech, very much placing the option of a second referendum on whether to stay inside the European Union very much on the table. Would you support a second referendum on those terms?
And I think we have to accept that the Prime Minister has led this negotiation for the United Kingdom now for 2.5 years. She's the lead negotiator for the UK. She thinks she can get a deal. Gibraltar thinks that we can get a deal in the context of the withdrawal agreement. Let us work towards that, and then let's skin the cat of what happens if there isn't a deal at that stage. We're doing a lot of work in the background to ensure that we are safe in those circumstances, that we know what no deal looks like for Gibraltar, and indeed that we might have a no deal deal for Gibraltar because of our specific geographic needs and circumstances.
Well, perhaps the hardest part of Brexit negotiations is still to be worked out, so a no deal scenario is still possible. And Emily Thornberry said that a no deal Brexit could have fundamental consequences for Gibraltar. But do you think that could be mitigated with a bilateral deal with Spain?
So a no deal scenario, of course, means that there are difficulties potentially there on the 30th of March. But those difficulties are mitigated in a number of ways. They're mitigated in particular if we're able to reach arrangements which relate to the practicalities of people who live on one side of the frontier and work on another, or who live on one side of the frontier and have relatives on the other, or people who want to visit Gibraltar, whether they live in the region or not. Those practicalities can be dealt with at a local level. Some of them can be dealt with at the level of competent authorities, some of which are Gibraltarian, some of which are Spanish. There doesn't have to be a macro deal between the United Kingdom and the European Union for us to be able to give logistic efficacy to people's ability to continue to live their lives as they have today after the 29th of March. But of course, it becomes much more difficult to do so. Then there are matters which depend on Brussels. So issues relating, for example, to European flights, an issue that doesn't affect Gibraltar because our flights are direct to the United Kingdom, but matters relating to social security, where information today is exchanged through Brussels, the European arrest warrant. There are non-day-to-day things which will be much more problematic and which we will need to find solutions for. But there are many people in the government of Gibraltar working on those issues too, so that we protect Gibraltarians and those who work in Gibraltar and those who want to visit Gibraltar from those potential scenarios as well.
Chief Minister, can you give us an indication of when your next talks with Spain are likely to take place?
Well, I can tell you that this is a constant and fluid process. In the 21st century, you don't need to be in the same room as someone to be able to be communicating and advancing things.